If you read the ingredient labels on your favorite chewing gum, you might see a sweetener called xylitol, which is a scary sounding word. Like, it's got the letter X in it, so surely that stuff can't be healthy. But it turns out there's a lot of evidence that xylitol can do a bunch of good things for us, like fighting infections, managing blood sugar, and even helping reduce preterm births. So pop some gum and let's get into it. Before we talk about what xylitol can do, let's talk about what it even is. Xylitol is a naturally occurring sugar alcohol that's found in mushrooms, some fruits, and other plant materials, and we've been putting more of it into our food since the mid-20th century. And a quick side note, while we know that xylitol is regarded as safe for humans, it is very dangerous for dogs, so no sharing with Fido. There are other sugar alcohols you might see on food labels, like sorbitol and erythritol. These all have a chemical structure that allows them to stimulate the sweetness receptors on our tongues. And xylitol is unique among the sugar alcohols because its shape lets it bind to those receptors really well, making it just as sweet as table sugar. But the structural difference means sugar alcohols are broken down differently and more slowly in the body than table sugar, so our bodies don't absorb them as efficiently. This means that while xylitol does have some calories, it contains around 40% fewer calories than sugar in terms of sheer energy, which may be why we started putting it in our food. And as it turns out, that was a sweet choice with a lot of added benefits, which start with your first bite. If you've heard of anything that xylitol is good for, it's probably that it's great for your teeth and gums. There are plenty of studies that show it can prevent tooth decay, especially in cavity-prone kids and adults. And you might think that the only reason that stuff sweetened with xylitol doesn't rot your teeth is just that there's not as much sugar in it. Since xylitol is found in a lot of sugar-free gum, it might seem like the dental health benefit is either from replacing sugar or the gum chewing itself. Which is true, since chewing stimulates the production of saliva, which washes away substances that erode tooth enamel. So chewing on any kind of gum will help at least a little bit, as long as it's not a sugar bomb. But there's also something about xylitol itself that packs a few cavity-fighting punches. First, multiple studies suggest that xylitol impedes the growth of bacteria that contribute to cavity formation. It seems to do this by getting in through the cell walls of certain types of pathogens and disrupting their metabolism. Cavity-causing pathogens love sugar, and the more they get, the more they can grow. When they digest that sucrose, it creates acidic byproducts that eat away at our teeth. But when the same bacteria chow down on xylitol instead of sucrose, their metabolisms get jammed up and they eventually run out of energy. So giving these sugar-hungry microbes xylitol stops them from multiplying and sticking to our teeth, and prevents them from making that decay-promoting acid. This is a big deal because bad oral bacteria have been implicated in various diseases like cancers, heart disease, and even Alzheimer's. So xylitol's ability to basically starve unwanted pathogens in the mouth could have ripple effects all throughout the body. Not only can it kill cavity-causing bacteria and dial down oral acidity, but combining xylitol with certain calcium products and fluoride may even help prevent the demineralization of teeth. Xylitol binds to calcium, creating a structure more resilient against acid damage or demineralization, and it allows that calcium to stick into your enamel before it can get washed away into the digestive tract. And not only does that help prevent demineralization, some studies suggest that it can even help remineralize enamel that people can lose over time. So early stages of tooth decay could be reversed with xylitol. And xylitol's ability to strengthen your tissues isn't just restricted to the mouth, it may also help your bones. See, your bones are actually changing a lot more than you might think they are. There's a constant rhythm of new bone getting built as older bone gets recycled, all of which keeps your bones strong and healthy. At least when it's all working like it should be. Sometimes the recycling part outpaces the rebuilding bones, resulting in issues like osteoporosis or arthritis. And one way we might be able to fix that mismatch is with xylitol. This improvement is partly due to increased acidity, not directly around the bones, but in the gut. See, sometimes the reason your bones can't rebuild as fast as they need to is if you're not absorbing enough calcium in your diet. But when xylitol enters the mix, it decreases the pH in your gut, helping your intestines absorb more calcium and minerals to use for bone rebuilding. Now, to be clear, most of the studies on xylitol's role in bone building have been done on rodents, where adding xylitol to their feed resulted in decreased bone resorption and increased bone density in rats. In at at least one study, researchers saw the bone-strengthening effects of ingesting xylitol just a couple days after the first dose. However, the amount studied were like a lot of xylitol, probably way more than a human would want to consume in a day. But a 2022 study using rabbits suggested that actually applying xylitol topically to bones may also help rebuild them too. In the study published in the Journal of Applied Veterinary Sciences, 24 white rabbits were anesthetized and had their femurs drilled into. Ouch! Amazingly, the group of rabbits that had xylitol applied directly to the break had way more new bone tissue than their untreated counterparts. That same study also tested whether xylitol in food sped up bone healing. And while they found that rabbits that got extra sweet treats did heal faster than the control group, both oral and topical xylitol had faster rates of healing. Who would have thought that the secret to faster bone healing was adding a candy coating? But before we keep talking about the many benefits of xylitol, let's talk funding, specifically ours.
Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. Brilliant is an online learning platform where you can build your knowledge through their fun and interactive lessons. Their easy-to-use platform lets you expand your horizons at your own pace, meaning that you're not limited to a traditional classroom schedule. With Brilliant and a smartphone, you can learn anytime, anywhere. In the doctor's office waiting room? Easy. Waiting for your train? Absolutely. On a date? I mean, maybe not the best idea, but that's your call. Brilliant certainly won't stop you. To try Brilliant for free, visit brilliant.org/scishow, scan the QR code on screen, or click the link in the video description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription.
Xylitol isn't just great for the parts of your body made of minerals. It can be super beneficial for your gut, too. Part of what makes xylitol special is the way that it's digested. It's something called a prebiotic, a type of fiber that feeds the beneficial bacteria in our gut and helps them thrive. See, our human tissues can't digest xylitol all alone. But certain types of good bacteria that normally colonize healthy digestive tracts can take xylitol in and happily ferment it into short-chain fatty acids, which help you absorb water and minerals, balance the pH of the colon, and feed even more of our microbial friends. For instance, in a 2024 study published in the journal Food and Chemical Toxicology, researchers used a colon simulator with fecal samples from children to study what happens in digestion with or without xylitol. They found that xylitol increased the production of butyrate, a fatty acid that provides energy to the cells of your colon. Xylitol's prebiotic power can be a good thing, but it's also kind of a double-edged sword, specifically because it can also have a laxative effect. Xylitol and other sugar alcohols have been known to cause diarrhea, especially in people who are more sensitive to them. This is one reason why there's a general warning against over-consuming it, which of course is true of pretty much all substances. This excessive pooping with too much xylitol happens because it's hydrophilic, meaning it draws water into itself, including when it's in the digestive tract. And that extra water helps move things along. But that also means that a dose of xylitol may also help with constipation. Some research even suggests that several doses of xylitol after surgery can help patients' bowels start moving again more quickly, reducing the amount of time patients need to wait around in the hospital. So xylitol could be just as good for you on the way out as it is on the way in. Yet another way that xylitol's structure makes it distinct is that it doesn't require as much insulin to break it down as sugar does. Plus, it may help control the accumulation of body fat. Part of this is for the obvious reason: replacing sugar with a lower calorie sweetener is going to naturally mean lower blood sugar. But again, xylitol seems to have its own diabetes-fighting tricks. Xylitol can stimulate enough insulin secretion at the right dose to help us process carbohydrates, and in diabetic individuals, it might get and keep insulin levels within a healthy range. You can think of insulin like a key that unlocks our cells, allowing glucose in to be used for energy. For people with type 2 diabetes, either the pancreas doesn't produce enough insulin, or their cells don't seem to get unlocked by that insulin key as efficiently, or sometimes both. That prevents sugar from getting into their tissues to be used as energy and causes it to build up in the blood. This excess sugar often ends up being stored as fat. A study in mice suggests that ingested xylitol may help cells respond to insulin, allowing them to take in and process glucose more efficiently. There's also evidence, largely in rats, that high doses of xylitol may be able to help pancreatic cells produce more insulin, which may also reduce the accumulation of body fat. All in all, the blood sugar benefits of this sucrose alternative make it pretty sweet. We've covered how xylitol fights bacteria in your mouth, but it turns out it has infection-fighting properties beyond your pearly whites, too. In the right conditions, xylitol seems to be able to bust biofilms, which are colonies of microorganisms that stick to various surfaces in clingy layers. If you've ever dealt with a stubborn, smelly drain or slipped on slimy rocks in a river, you've had a run-in with a biofilm. The plaque on our teeth is an example of a biofilm, too. And while some biofilms are pretty annoying, some other biofilms are actually pretty helpful in the right circumstances. But one place we don't want biofilms is on our skin. While everyone's skin is teeming with various species of bacteria, people with bad eczema tend to have specific types of bacteria populating their skin that aren't found in people without the condition, at least not in such high quantities. And there's evidence that xylitol can damage these unwanted skin microbes. A 2005 study published in the Journal of Dermatological Science found that a xylitol solution could dissolve a biofilm of staphylococcus bacteria that researchers grew on collagen-coated plastic, and it could also prevent the formation of new staph biofilms too. The same researchers also conducted a small clinical study on 6 eczema patients in Japan back in 1999. They found that application of a cream that contained 5% xylitol, along with other active ingredients, significantly reduced the presence of this problematic pathogen. And when applied topically, xylitol may also help skin with wound healing by reducing moisture loss and accelerating the repair of the skin barrier, which is a layer of skin tissue that holds in moisture. Some in vitro studies suggest that xylitol may also fight infections in the nose, throat, and ears. It may even help inhibit or kill pathogens that cause all kinds of ailments like ear infections, pneumonia, and flu, although the studies in vivo, aka in us, vary. And there's even more. These infection-fighting benefits of xylitol may help with the next generation too, even when they're still in utero. Researchers conducted a randomized controlled trial lasting over 3 years of over 10,000 pregnant or soon-to-be pregnant people in Malawi, a country with a really high rate of preterm birth. In their paper published in the journal Med in 2024, they reported that expectant mothers who chewed xylitol gum had a whopping 24% reduction in preterm births over the course of their study. See, researchers have known for a while that periodontal disease during pregnancy is associated with negative birth outcomes. And since people in Malawi also have high rates of periodontal disease, these researchers thought they could hit both birds with one pack of gum. So it's possible that this positive effect of xylitol on pregnancy outcomes is a byproduct of reducing periodontal disease. In any case, it's pretty amazing that a simple ingredient in candy may help fetuses and newborn babies whose teeth haven't even come in yet. So there's a lot that xylitol can do for us, from head to toe, and it's a great reminder that some substances that might sound a bit scary can have their perks too.